Swiss pharma giant Novartis presses ahead with its research and development efforts in its fight against COVID-19. The firm is also manufacturing hydroxychloroquine for donation purposes. With us now for more is Christine Fajardo, Country Corporate Affairs Head, Novartis Healthcare Philippines, Inc. Good to see you, Christine. Welcome to the program.
Yeah, good to see you, Kathy. Good morning, and thank you for the opportunity to share our global response to help combat the pandemic.
Now, sure. So what is the status now of your donations of the hydroxychloroquine? Because the FDA on Friday cautioned against the use of the anti-malarial drug or chloroquine for COVID-19 outside the hospital setting or clinical trial because of the risk of heart rhythm problems.
No. Just to contextualize, Kathy, Novartis is deeply dedicated to doing our part in supporting the stability of global healthcare systems. And the HCQ, or hydroxychloroquine donation, is part of a broad set of initiatives to expand treatment capacity of the healthcare system. So with that, Novartis has, through our biosimilars and generic division, Sandoz, committed to donate up to 130 million doses of hydroxychloroquine. Now, on the US FDA MedWatch safety alert, Novartis agrees with a safety alert for investigational medicines. This is the reason why Novartis has entered into a research agreement with the US Food and Drug Administration to proceed to a phase 3 clinical study and evaluate the use of hydroxychloroquine involving 440 patients for treatment of hospitalized patients with COVID-19 disease. Also take note, Kathy, that even the World Health Organization has embarked on a solidarity trial, and I'm happy that our country is participating in this WHO-led solidarity trial investigating four treatments. One of the treatment options there is the hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine.
So the clinical trial 3 carries on despite the warning from the FDA, just to be clear.
Yes, precisely. This is important in our commitment to patient safety and health. The purpose of clinical trials is to help ensure that the medicines we bring will be safe and benefit more patients. We are working closely with the governments and the scientific community and patients to conduct these studies.
And what about the donations of the HCQ to treat hospitalized COVID-19 patients? You've donated as well to Switzerland earlier this month, second in the world after the U.S., apart from the 130 million doses that you just mentioned that is committed to the Philippines.
Yes, so in line with that, as I mentioned, an important priority for us is to help strengthen the treatment capacity of the healthcare system. This is where we want to support the healthcare system. And so in the Philippines, Novartis is donating through our biosimilars and generics division, Sando, we are donating 25,000 doses to the Department of Health based on the guidelines issued by the Philippine Society of Microbiology and Infectious Diseases. This is underway.
And here in the Philippines, I'm aware that Novartis has begun the ruxolitinib compassionate use of the program for COVID-19 patients. What is the strategy of this drug, and what is the timeline for clinical study?
So perhaps to also give you an overview of the research initiatives of Novartis before discussing ruxolitinib. We have three categories of research initiatives. First, Novartis joined two key cross-industry research collaborations, and one is the COVID-19 Therapeutics Accelerator, coordinated by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Wellcome and MasterCard, and also is the other COVID-19 directed partnership organized by the Innovative Medicines Initiative. Also, secondly, in a response to an urgent call issued by the European Federation of Pharmaceutical Industries and Associations for research and development on coronavirus, Novartis is making available several compounds from our compound libraries that are considered suitable for in vitro antiviral testing. Now, the third component is that we are rapidly evaluating existing medicines to see if they can be used beyond approved indications. Ruxolitinib is one of our existing medicines that we are evaluating for treatment of severe patients. Preclinical and preliminary clinical evidence suggests that ruxolitinib could reduce the number of patients requiring intensive care and mechanical ventilation. So on April 2, 2020, Novartis, in collaboration with Incyte, entered into a announced its plan for a phase 3 clinical study of ruxolitinib in the evaluation of its use for patients with severe COVID-19 disease.
Final point, Christine, how are you carrying on with your business contingency plans in the Philippine office? What are some of the logistical issues you've been running up against under the enhanced community quarantine, delivering medicines to hospitals and drug stores in Luzon?
Yeah, our primary concern, Kathy, is the safety and health of our associates and patients around the world. And it is very important that we protect them. So very important that we continue to deliver medicines to patients. We do not see supply chain disruptions or issues in majority of our portfolio due to strong mitigation measures of the company and inventory levels. Now, in the Philippines, we are monitoring the situation very closely. And to help patients with questions on product availability, we have also inputted the number of the contact details of retailers and associates in our website, novartis.com.ph. A very important component, Kathy, is how to help our associates cope with extended community quarantine. And we are implementing our 3H program, wherein we help our associates keep energized, be energized, and positive to promote healthy living, as well as promote messages on hygiene and social distancing. And the third H in this 3H program is how our associates could lend a helping hand for impacted individuals or communities impacted by the pandemic. So here we take a holistic approach with our associates as well as patients. With the patients, we help ensure supply of medicines. With our associates, we through our virtual touch points, we tell them that this is actually the perfect moment to create a vision of ourselves, to create a vision of success for the new normal. What skills, attributes, and qualities do we need to be able to be our best while working remotely, and at the same time, being fully present with our family members, how to set boundaries where there is none. And so overall, Kathy, we have a holistic program that aims to help keep our associates positive and have a sense of control to be able to contribute to live our mission of extending and improving lives.
All right. Well, thank you so much for keeping us up to speed on the progress in the clinical trials. Touch base with us if there is a breakthrough. Thank you and keep well, Christine.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathy, for an energizing conversation. Keep well.
You too.
And I look forward to connecting with you.
All right. Christine Fajardo of Novartis, Philippines.